We know how to solve one-variable linear equations, so how about two? Well, two variables or two equations? Both. We got two variables, x and y, and two equations. They're linear equations, that means each of the variables is raised to just the first power. And we want to find values of x and y that satisfy both of these equations at the same time. Now, if we could figure out one of them, we could easily, quickly get the other one. Like, if we had a value for x, we can put it right in there, and we'll instantly get y. If we had y, we could put it right in there, and we'll instantly get x. But, we don't have either one of them. So we don't have a number that we can just put in here for x to get y. But we do have a whole expression here. We do know that x is 3y plus 7. So we can take this whole expression and put it right in there for x. Let's see what that'll do for us. We put this expression, 3y plus 7, we're going to substitute that in for x, just like we would substitute a number in if we knew what number x equaled. And we'll get y is 5 times 3y plus 7 plus 7. And this is an equation we know how to handle. This is just a one-variable linear equation. We expand the product on the right-hand side, we get 5 times 3y is 15y, 5 times 7 is 35, and we have the plus 7. So we get y is 15y plus 42. Subtract the 15y from both sides, we get negative 14y equals 42. So we divide by negative 14 and we get y is negative 3. And now we can come back up here and find out what x goes with this by just putting negative 3 in here for y. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9. Add the 7, you get negative 2. And the way we like to write this solution is we write x comma y inside the parentheses. We call this an ordered pair. The order is very important because we're going to match that order over here. We're going to say x comma y is negative 2 comma negative 3. And these numbers go in the same order as these variables. The negative 2 goes with x. Negative 3 goes with y. And we can test that this solution is correct by putting these values in to these equations up here. Put in negative 2 for x, we get negative 2 on this side, put in negative 3 up here. 3 times negative 3 is negative 9, plus 7 is negative 2. That's what we did to find x in the first place, so that better work. But we still have to check the other equation. We'll put in negative 2 and negative 3 again for x and y. Put in negative 3 for y, you have negative 3 over here. And then here we have 5 times negative 2 is negative 10 plus 7. That gives us negative 3. So this equation works as well. And we found our solution. And we call this a system of equations. We have multiple equations here that all have to be satisfied at the same time. We call that a system of equations. And we've just solved that one. So let's try this one. We've got another system of equations, but here we aren't told. Well, back here we were told what x is in terms of y and y is in terms of x. And it was easy for us to just substitute this expression in for x, but here all the variables, the p's and the q's, are all on this side. So what can we do? I mean, if we had just like p equals stuff in terms of q, we could substitute, or q equals stuff in terms of p, we could substitute. That's what we should do. We can turn one of these equations into an equation that looks like this. We can solve for one of the variables in terms of the other. And this is the easiest one to solve for. This p is all alone. All these others have something multiplied by the variable. It's going to be harder to solve for those. So we'll start with this equation right here. We'll subtract 12q from both sides. And that'll give us p equals minus 8 minus 12q. And now we're right back where we were in the previous problem. We've got p in terms of q. We can substitute this in for p in the second equation. And we have 3 times our expression here for p plus 4q equals 8. One variable linear equation. We're all set now. We know how to handle this. 3 times negative 8 is negative 24. 3 times negative 12 is negative 36. So 3 times negative 12q is 3 times is negative 36q. And we're going to add 4q, and that still equals 8. So we'll add the 24 to both sides. We'll get 32 over here. We'll combine the negative 36q plus 4q. That gives us negative 32q. And then we divide both sides by negative 32. And we get q is negative 1. And now we can come back up here and find p. We put the negative 1 in here for q. Minus 12 times minus 1, that gives us a plus 12. Then we subtract the 8, and we get 4. And once again, we can write this down as an ordered pair. The ordered pair pq equals 4, negative 1. Again, the order here is very important. The 4 goes with the p, the negative 1 goes with the q. And we can test it. We'll go ahead and put these back in these two equations. Make sure our answer does indeed satisfy both of these equations. Put in 4 for p, well, it's just 4. 12 times negative 1 is negative 12. 4 minus 12 is negative 8. So that one works. Now we're also going to put this into this second equation here. Make sure that works. 3 times 4 is 12. 4 times minus 1 is minus 4. 12 minus 4 is 8. Now notice that when we're testing these, we go back to the very original equations, the original ones in the problem. We don't test them by sticking them in one of these equations, because we might have made a mistake in going from here to one of these. We take our final answer and substitute it into the very original problem to test it. All right, let's try one more. Hey, wait a second. All the variables here are multiplied by something. I mean, back here it was easy. We're given x in terms of y. It was easy to substitute right away. And here it wasn't so hard either, because p was all by itself. All we had to do was subtract off the 12q. But here we can't just, you know, subtract or add something and have r or s in terms of the other one. What are we going to do? Well, when I get a little confused like this, I try to think of a simpler problem that looks a lot like this one. What would this be like if I just got rid of that s? If we just had 8r minus 6 equals 25? Well, we'd add the 6 to both sides, and then we divide by 8. We divide by the number, the coefficient, that number that's multiplied by the variable. That's how we get rid of it. So what we'll do here to solve for one of these variables in terms of the other is we'll get one of the variable terms alone and then divide by the number we're multiplying the variable by. So let's try that for this first equation. If we started off in this first equation, we just add 6s to both sides. We'll get 8r equals 25 plus 6s. We can get the r all by itself by dividing by 8. Divide both sides by 8. And we have, yuck. Yeah, that's not very appealing. I'm going to take this, I'm going to substitute it in here, I'm going to multiply that by negative 5, and have this fraction with a big denominator. You know, that'll work. It'll take some work, but it'll work. We'll get the right answer. What I'd like to do is go back to this and find an easier way. Find an easier way. Maybe one of these other things is easier to solve for, you know. I like small denominators in my fractions, not big ones. So I'm going to go back. I'm going to start this problem over again. I'm going to aim at that one right there. I'm going to solve for that s, because hopefully that'll make life a little bit easier. Let's check it out. All right, so I'm going to add 5r to both sides right up here, and I'll have 3s equals minus 16 plus 5r. Now I'm going to divide both sides by 3. And that'll get s all by itself. And we see here, we can start off by solving for either variable in either equation. And we want to pick the one that makes life easiest, because we like it when life is easier. Here we have a nice, it's a smaller denominator, but wait, there's something even better coming. When I substitute this in up here, I'm going to be multiplying by a negative 6. Negative 6 over 3. That's an integer. We don't have any more fractions. We like that. So we're going to take this expression for s, substitute it in right here, and we're going to have 8r minus 6 times this mess, negative 16 plus 5r. We have to be very careful when we're doing each of these steps that we copy everything down right. Don't make a mistake. Don't rush. Now we're going to rewrite this. I'm going to rewrite this as 8r minus 6 over 3 times negative 16 plus 5r. Because that makes it very clear that we have some really nice cancellation going on here. Bye-bye fractions. And now we have a simple linear equation that we can solve. Now, we won't always be able to avoid fractions like this, but when you see an opportunity to avoid them, get a nice little cancellation there, get a simpler equation, we definitely want to go for that. Multiply this out. We have negative 2 times negative 16. That gives us a plus 32. Negative 2 times a plus 5r gives us minus 10r. It's 25. Now over here, I'm going to go 8r minus 10r is going to give me minus 2r. I'm going to subtract 32 from both sides. That gives me negative 7. And that tells me that r, divide both sides by negative 2, we'll get r is 7 halves. But we're not done. We need s as well. We got to substitute this r back up into here. I'm going to go ahead and separate this. I'm going to substitute this 7 halves back into here to figure out what s is. Let's see, we'll get negative 16 plus, that's 35 over 2. 7 halves times the 5, all of this divided by 3. Okay, this is negative 32 over 2 plus 35 over 2. All over 3. Almost there. This is 3 halves. Still divided by 3. 3 halves divided by 3, well, that's just 1 half. And now we've got our solution. R is 7 halves, and S is 1 half. And of course, we still got to check it. We'll check these by putting them back up here. If I put 7 halves in here for R, 8 times 7 halves, 8 divided by 2 gives us 4, 4 times 7 is 28. So that's 28 minus 6 times a half. 6 times a half is just 3. 28 minus 3 is 25. Whew, that one works. Now we got to try the second one. Negative 5 times 7 halves. That gives us negative 35 over 2 plus 3 halves. 3 times a half. Negative 35 over 2 plus 3 halves gives us negative 32 over 2. That's negative 16. So we've checked both of these work, and we've got our solution. Our solution is 7 halves, 1 half for RS. Whew, that was an awful lot of work. You know, I bet there's an easier way to do this problem.